So
before I get started, I grew up in Michigan. I went to Arizona. My mom still lives in Michigan, and every time I'm gonna do something, my mom's always like, "Hey, if you're gonna do something cool, can you send me a picture?"
So cool, Roger.
So for those of us that haven't met, and I'll see a lot of familiar faces in the room, my name is Roger Wagner, and I have the distinct pleasure of teaching music at Deseret Middle School. Specifically, this year, I actually get to teach just instrumental music, which is a big thing for us, but we'll talk about that in just a moment. So a little bit about me. This is my fifth year at Deseret. We've aggressively expanded our program. I'll talk about that in a little bit. But what I want to talk to you about is thinking about you and less about me. What is your brand as a teacher? Do you know what your brand is? Do your colleagues know what your brand is? Do your students know what your brand is? Big idea number one, and not just as a teacher, but for all of us, is that your body of work is the best part of your brand. What you produce will always outweigh what you put on your resume. Or I'm the assistant marching band director at the high school as well. We always talk about what you put on the field is important. So specifically for me in Deseret Performing Arts, this has been a journey. Because 5 years ago when I started working at NUSD, we had about 100 students, or 1 in 4 at Deseret Wind. This year in Deseret Wind Performing Arts, we have about 400 students throughout the school year, 56% or 1 in 2 students. So what we've learned is that a lot can happen in 5 years. And not only can a lot happen, but we can also experience and meet a lot of wonderful students and learn a lot of work. Now, you might be asking yourself this question, in 4 or 5 years, how does a program grow about 300 students or almost exponentially? Well, one of the things that we found, not only as a program, but as a music department, is that we want to focus on a very specific word in education, because we believe some of the most important words in education are the smallest ones. Those words are two, for, and with. Now, let's talk about those prepositions for just a moment. I made a language arts connection. So, to is something that often is absent of the person that's happening to, right? It's someone doing something to them, like, I'm going to smack you, I'm doing that to you. For, we often tend to think about as something we're doing to save a student. What we're primarily concerned with, and what we've seen help our program a lot, is with. Involving our students not only with decisions, but with performances, with choosing some of the content, and with what they're doing, enough that they were empowered, engaged, and we found a lot more students being drawn to it. Now, my math teacher friends, I know you're going, I don't want more kids in my room, but I know you do want that kid in the back row to wake up, pay attention, and be engaged with what you're doing. And by involving your students or asking them to be a part of those decisions, you can get that. Part two, a big idea, is the best way to brand yourself is to express yourself. If you've met me, like Mallory Miller would describe, I have very strong opinions. And that's the way I express myself. But specifically because I'm looking to make connections, and connections are shared value. So my ask for you is, how is your brand? How are you communicating as an educator or in education? How are you promoting your brand? And how are you sharing you as a person? How are you sharing it? To talk a little bit about the journey of me, Roger coming out of school wore a dress shirt and tie every day, spoke very formally with his colleagues, and then went home and took his dress shirt and tie off, and wasn't the person he was at work. And that was a problem. Because it created a cognitive dissonance for me, and it made me question, am I being honest and sincere in myself to my students? Because that's one of the best things is, as people in education, we can share are ourselves. So Roger's brand part two is not only being myself, but aggressively being myself to the extent that there's a very, very, very distinct thing you can see, not only me and the way I interact with my kids, but the way our program works. And you see, like, I'm a nerd, hey, I'm surrounded by nerds. So what I said about doing is to be able to individually identify and be a part of this program with my students. Not the textbook definition of the program, not what the evaluation might say about the program, but being me. Now, what does that mean for you? fringe benefits for me where I started to have a lot better relationships with colleagues. I started to have people I was friends with because I wasn't concerned with being someone else. I was being honest with myself. What that also means for you and your students, adolescents are really great nonsense detectors, right? They know. So my challenge for you, my colleagues, as we step into this year, is not to go out and be the best textbook you, but to be the best you. Because that version of you is what brought you into education. It's what makes the impact and the difference in lives of students each and every single day. My name is Roger Wagner. My brand is Student Empowerment and Being Myself. What's yours?